He's become a TV celebrity after winning the 8th season of the Food Network's Food Network Star Competition. Chef Justin Warner, welcome to The Dish.
Hey, thanks very much. I'm so enthusiastic. This is really, really exciting.
My name's Justin Warner. I'm a TV chef. I live in New York City. And to me, the world seems a little messed up lately.
The global refugee situation really demands for different thinking and approach. Globally today, we are talking about an estimated 66 million plus refugees. My name is Bernard Ochieng. I'm serving as the country director for the American Refugee Committee, working in Rwanda.
Okay, so quick update. I got connected with the American Refugee Committee about opening a restaurant in one of their camps. They loved my idea. So believe it or not, I'm headed to Rwanda to see if this is possible.
So after 20 hours of flying, we've made it to Kigali. And honestly, our journey is not over yet. We still have about a 4-hour drive. I want to say 3 on roads, 1 on dirt road.
So we just arrived here at the Mahama camp. As you can see, it goes on and on. The first thing that I'm going to do is talk to the camp manager to see if opening a restaurant would be helpful here.
How do you do?
It's a good idea to open the restaurant in the camp. We have a market, so we have everything here. If we can afford to create a restaurant, very nice to us and to refugees.
So I've traveled the world over, I've cooked the world over, and I've even opened my own successful restaurant. The reason for a restaurant is because restaurants are there to restore. And the idea is that a restaurant can employ people, it can feed people, it can teach people, and can become kind of this like cultural hub.
Nice.
These are tree tomatoes, also known as tamarillo, and as they ripen, they actually kind of blur the line between like sweet and savory. They're pretty remarkable. I'd love to use these as like a juice in a vinaigrette. I think it would be wicked.
So the good news is there's a great food supply chain not far from here. The next thing that we have to figure out is location. And just like New York, location, location, location.
You can see there's a lot of commercial activity going on here, like bike repair shop, a couple little cafes, you know, but I think we should see what else is on the market.
So here we have a little less traffic, but I mean, the view can't be beat. We also got a little empty lot right over there. So we're just a little bit outside of the camp here, and what's unique about this spot, unlike the others, is that we can get traffic from both directions. The people that are visiting the camp and trading, and the people that are leaving the camp to go do other things. So I think this might be kind of like the smart business decision. I want to employ people from the camp here, and at the end of all of this, I want to just pass it on and leave it to them.
So we got ourselves some primo ingredients from the market, and now all we have to do is see if there's any interest in cooking from members of the camp.
Red fishies, some potato, corn, little celeries. Do you know mise en place? So mise en place is we get everything ready first, because when you're running a restaurant, you know, maybe you're just gonna take one handful and go. And you have to do that 50 times, you know? If you put too much stuff in the pan, there's not enough oil, one, and there's not enough contact, surface area. There's no salt in the dish, so it's not finished. So for salt, we do it from way up high. So we do salt, way up high. Celery leaves, one toss, two toss, put it on the plate, et voila. Okay, so this one, two. So right now we're heating the curry to activate the spices. Smells good? So one thing in the restaurant is everything has to be consistent. So if I put the green beans at say 3 o'clock, and the carrots at noon. Carrots are noon every plate. Carrots are 3 o'clock every plate, you know what I mean? Bon appetit.
So I didn't know what to expect coming to the Mahama refugee camp with a giant project like this. Is it responsible? Is it appreciated? Will it be helpful? Well, we got a lot of those questions answered. But the real question is, can I make a sustainable, economically viable restaurant in a refugee camp? I made a restaurant in New York. That was tough enough. Who knows how this adventure is going to end?